So I've got a couple of questions for you. Number one, when was the last time you had your vitamin D checked, or have you ever had it checked? And number two is, what was the reading when you had it done? So I'm asking these questions because vitamin D plays quite a crucial role in insulin sensitivity. So your insulin sensitivity is basically how good you are at regulating your blood sugar levels, and therefore, you know, how easily you go into fat burning mode. So I ask you about your vitamin D level because vitamin D is important for helping to regulate insulin sensitivity. So if you have a deficiency in vitamin D, then you might be more prone to something called insulin resistance, which is where your insulin isn't able to perform its job properly and your body has to produce more and more insulin to move your sugar into your blood, into your cells. So when you have high levels of insulin, you're in fat storage mode. And obviously that's not good if you want to lose weight. So if you have a deficiency in vitamin D, it could be playing a role in your weight management. So have you had a test in the last year? If not, get one. And do you know what the result was? If not, get a printout, because your doctor will often tell you that your vitamin D was normal. But what's normal to them is, you know, they're trying to prevent rickets. They're trying to prevent, you know, serious illness. But actually, you know, the level that is considered to be normal isn't actually high enough to allow your body to function optimally. So, if your reading was near 50, then your doctor will tell you that it was normal, but actually your level should be at about 100. So that's quite a big difference. So if you're, you know, lower than 100, then you might benefit from supplementing. Depends on the time of year. If you're just a bit lower than 100 at the moment, then it's probably going to go up as we go into the summer. But if you're sitting somewhere around 50, or even lower than that, then you definitely need a supplement to bring your level up. So a few considerations. So firstly, some people are not very good at storing vitamin D, and that can be a genetic thing. So for some people, no matter how much you supplement, you might not be able to bring your vitamin D level up very much, or at least you might not be able to maintain that. So for some people, supplementing vitamin D constantly is essential. Also, as we get older, we become worse at storing vitamin D because the body composition changes and we tend to replace muscle with fat, and that means that we don't store vitamin D so well. If you're an older person and actually you've got a very good muscle mass and low body fat percentage, then you may be better at storing vitamin D. So my advice to you is go and get your vitamin D level checked if you haven't had it done in the last year, and find out what that reading actually is. Don't just take your doctor's word for it that it's normal. If you are below 100, or, you know, perhaps below 75 at this time of year, then you need a supplement, and you should speak to your doctor or book a consultation with me to talk about it, about what you should be supplementing specifically, because supplementing vitamin D alone isn't always an effective way of topping up your vitamin D, and the dosage you should be taking depends on your level and several other factors like your ethnicity and that sort of thing. So I hope you found that helpful. Drop me a comment if you have got anything to say or have got any questions, and I hope you found this useful. Speak to you soon.